blessed are the poor in spirit, for they will realize their need for God. See, there's this direct connection between our need for God and our need for other things. See, Jesus uses this example of the poor. He says, you know, the poor actually have needs. They have physical needs. They need food, they need water, they need shelter, they need clothing. They need those things. And see, if they need those things, who do they get them from? And so they're relying on God constantly. And if we, you know, as somebody that has, we've grown up in a privileged situation, we have those things taken care of, sometimes we forget our need for God. We forget that we have to rely on Him in every situation. We don't have any physical needs that really need provided for in this moment. Directly comes back to the poor and says, you know, blessed are the people that understand what that situation is like. Not necessarily the poor are blessed, but the people that see how the poor rely on God to give them food, to give them water, to give them shelter, to daily provide for those needs. Those are the things that we can take away from that situation and say, okay, I need God daily. I need God in every situation. Jesus says in Matthew 25, if you do to the least of these, you do it to me. So if we get a cup of water and we give that to somebody, we are doing that to Jesus. You know, in all these things, we directly relate the poor and our need for God. And when I actually find myself in these situations where I'm providing for somebody else's need, it becomes so clear how much we both need God. How much, you know, physically we can take care of needs. Sometimes, you know, I'm really good at providing for my own needs. I'm really good at saying I can do this on my own. But what's interesting is when I help other people, when I provide for somebody else's need, I realize my own need for God. I need to start making a difference in the needs of other people's lives. So how do we do that? I look around me and in downtown Houston, there is so much need, whether that's shelter, whether that's clothing, whether that's food, Medicare, water. All those things are things that these people need physically. They need these things to be provided for them. And we as the church, we need to help them understand their need for God. But first, I think we need to provide for some of their physical needs. Good God, can you still get us home? Good God, can you still get us home?